didn't see you there. Good morning, Carterville. I'm Chantel Marvilla. Today is Friday, May 6, 2022, and you're watching Carterville AM. A new club is starting up for the next school year, the Pre-Med Club. This club will provide Carterville students with an outlet to explore future schooling and career opportunities in any aspect or area of medicine. Medical school, optometry, psychiatry, physical therapy, physician assistant, and biomedical research, etc. To provide a resource to students looking for a chance to intern, job shadow, and learn from current professionals in different medical fields, we are looking for several officer positions to be filled. If you are interested, scan the QR code posted outside Ms. Bowman's room 103A upstairs by the science hallway, or send her an email to get the link to sign up. And thank you to everyone who came out to audition to be an anchor on Carterville AM. We had a great turnout and a difficult decision. The following students will be joining our anchors next year: Jordan Lewin, Madison Nolan, and Parnika Pongdala. They will be joining returning anchors Julia Amick, Michaela Brown, Colin Compton, Nick Douglas, William Yergi, Jenna Grace Yachman, Nick Luter, Jalissa Miller, Aiden Pettit, Ellie Sawyer, and Alina Sikander, and Christy Young. And now for a special message from our Carterville AM production crew.
Is this thing on?
So, today we want to apologize about something.
Guys, we are so sorry to let you down. We never wanted it to come to this. The situation just got so messy and out of control. So
for that, we're so sorry. What are you talking about? This is a senior show.
Oh. The senior show is where we take time to commemorate, honor, and be appreciative of the time we've spent with our seniors and be thankful for them for helping us run Carterville AM every single morning.
We've made some amazing memories with these guys, and now we want to share those memories with you.
Well, it's that time again.
Welcome to the senior show.
When I first met Margo, I just knew that she was gonna be one of like the coolest people in our class.
She brightens up my day every time I walk in this classroom. I'm going to miss her so much next year because I don't know who I'm gonna have these lovely conversations with.
I thought that Jackson was really, really quiet. He didn't really talk. But then I just kind of started saying hi to him in the mornings, and now he'll always ask me, like, how's your morning going? How's your day going? I look forward to talking with him in the mornings.
Carlos is just a vibrant person. You know, he gets everyone smiling, he gets everyone laughing. Oh, favorite memory of Carlos, that's easy. Some days he'll go to the back of the room and he'll put on a beat, he'll start freestyling, or he's already got raps written down. It's so funny, it's the best. Everyone's watching him. Even if everyone's watching him, he keeps going.
I would describe Clarence as a really fun guy. He doesn't really hold back on who he is.
I really enjoy getting to spend time with him. He'll give me rides home sometimes, and we have like literally the best conversations ever.
The way I would describe Sophia is just, she is extremely creative. She always just comes up with the most creative things. She has like some of my favorite videos.
Sophia's made our Adult Swim intro, which was really cool to see. She's very creative, very talented. So my first impression of Jonathan was that he was really quiet. I, over time, got used to him, and like we started talking.
Jonathan is a crazy good editor. Some of the stuff I've never seen anything that good for our school. Overall, he's just like a really cool, diverse person.
Musa is very reliable, very dependable. He always shows up and tries to do his best.
Musa's best quality is how reliable he is. Every day he'll come in, even if he's not asked in the morning, and help out.
My first impression of Peyton is that he's very smart. He's always willing to do CG.
I honestly think we couldn't run a Carterville AM some days without him.
Hepler, Bo Ashton Hepler. You know, probably one of my favorite people in the class. Bo's the definition of a helping hand.
He never panics. If he's directing, he always makes sure everyone's cool, calm, and collected, which is really nice.
My first impression of Erin is that she's very large and in charge. I feel like she's very powerful.
Erin is very meticulous in her work. She's taught me a lot. She's helped me with a lot of projects. She's given me lots of advice.
Ethan, there's so much to say about Ethan. He's fun, he's creative, he's so laid back, it's envious. When he does the Ethan Eats, everyone kind of makes fun of him for it, but it's okay because it takes a lot of guts to go up there and actually do that.
Such a fun person, and he really does bring a lot of new things to the table.
Ethan means a lot to me. Ethan is actually my director. He's my personal director. He's showed me the ropes of directing Collierville AM. He's showed me how to stay chill when, you know, a problem occurs. He's showed me how to help everyone get through the problem. He always has my back anytime someone says something to me, because he's my director. I got his back, he's got my back. That's how it is.
I would describe Savage as like such a hard worker. He is my director and he really has taught me a lot of like things that I didn't know.
I'm his assistant director, so he means the world. He's taught me so many things, from running Collierville AM to gain more confidence in what I do, to even helping me become, you know, who I am today.
Savage's best quality would for sure be being able to like take over a room.
He takes control of the room very easily.
Just whenever he's directing, you just know that you have to do what he is saying.
The impression of Pringle is that he was very funny and we have very similar senses of humor.
Pringle is definitely one of my role models in my life.
He's my director and we just kind of got along from day one.
He has been one of my best friends this year, and I really do look up to him, and I'm very sad having to see him leave the school.
Good morning, Collierville. This is Drew Savage. Normally, I'm one of the many people behind the camera producing Collierville AM. It has been my privilege to help create content, direct the live show, and lead this amazing crew. This role has given me the opportunity to see up close some of the coolest moments that happened throughout the school year. The incredible football season we had last fall, the musical plays and shows put on by our incredible theater department, and of course, everyone's favorite segment, Ethan Eats. As fun as this show is, it simply would not be a show without you, our audience, both our classmates and the administration. We are grateful for this opportunity to do this show. It has given all of us invaluable experience that will benefit us well beyond our time here at CHS. And to Mr. Jones, thank you for making this possible. Thank you for participating in Hot Seat. And thank you especially for your patience with the process and all the shenanigans that occasionally happen on this show. In closing, as myself and my fellow seniors conclude our time here at CHS, we cannot forget to recognize our teachers. Thank you for putting up with us these last 4 years. Your impact on our lives will definitely not be forgotten. And personally, I want to thank Mr. Robbins, our film teacher. Thank you for putting me in this incredible position, for taking a personal interest in me and my future, and modeling to all of us here what it means to be the standard. To the class of 2022, I wish each of you the best of luck wherever your journey takes you. And now for the quote of the day. Don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. Dr. Seuss. And for the last time, that's all we have for you, Collierville. Have a sensational summer and a fantastic future.
Go Dragons!